Nachi Valley Refugee Settlement has a number of marginalized children of school-going age. Many learners come from child-headed families, and some struggle to cultivate and look for food to cater for the needs of their families, while others are kept home to handle house chores. According to Evelyn Nalugave, the head teacher of Nachi Valley Primary School, there was a low turn-up of students as the term commenced, and this was attributed to a number of factors.
First and foremost, learners, they don't feed at school. They are lacking food. Even at home, they don't have food. When you are going there up, you meet all the learners moving up and down, looking for food in the villages. And this results into absenteeism, hence poor performance.
Rashid Achup, the head teacher at Nachi Valley SS, also attributed the low turn-up of students to high poverty levels.
Paying the efforts that it is putting, because the attitudes of the parents are changing and you find them reporting to school. However, my wish is normally the timing, because if you start the campaign 1 week to the return of students to learners, you find that also parents will start their preparations a little late, especially looking for monies to buy scholastic materials.
Nachi Valley SS closed with a total of 1,400 learners last term. However, less than half of the students have reported. A number of factors have been attributed to the low turn-up, absenteeism and high dropout of refugees from schools, and these include lack of scholastic materials, language barrier, among others.
As they are still there in the villages because they have first to look for food before they come to school. They are digging to make sure that next time they get food. So most of them, they are still there in the villages. So we need help to get some people to mobilize them, the learners, to return back to school.
Recognizing this urgent need, the Norwegian Refugee Council has launched a project funded by Education Cannot Wait in Nachi Valley Refugee Settlement to improve access to inclusive and gender transformative learning and training opportunities.
Materials, things to do with scholastic materials, things that really can make their life easier at school. So we really provide some of the things. And also we have been able to facilitate the school management committees to really look into some of the day-to-day runnings of this school and make sure that they are up to par, so that most of these learners receive an inclusive education.
Odur says the project actively engages parents, local leaders, and other stakeholders to foster a sense of ownership and create a supportive ecosystem that values education.
We have instituted strategies such as having return to learning facilitators that move within the communities and really look at some of the specific challenges that these children are facing and try to address some of these specific challenges, and as such, inspire them to come back to school.
Residents have hailed the Norwegian Refugee Council and the Education Cannot Wait project. They hope it will improve education services in their area. Nachi Valley, a refugee settlement in southwest Uganda, is home to over 100,000 refugees from various countries, including Democratic Republic of Congo, Burundi, Rwanda, and South Sudan. In these difficult circumstances, education is often ignored as families struggle to meet their basic needs. Story compiled by Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news.